ಅನುದಿನಾ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್
ಕಸನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hello, good morning children. How are you all? Fine, very good children. Children, welcome to Samveda E-Class 5th Standard, English 2nd Language. Let's, children, I am going to ask few questions to you. Here is the questions. First one, children tell me, what do you do when you come to the school in the morning? What do you do? When you come to the school in the morning? Yes, you play, right? Very good, children. Then, now tell me, children, whom do you play with? Yes, you are going to play with your friends. Sometime you are going to play with your students, friends, parents, and sometimes with your neighbors also. Now tell me, children, why do you need friends? Why do you need friends? Yes, you need friends to play. Then, no children, you need friends not only to play but also to share your feelings, ideas and thoughts, isn't it? Yes, fine. Next children, can we make only human beings or living things as friends? Listen children, can we make only human beings or living things as friends? Yes, then why can't we have friendship with the non-living things? Why can't we have friendship with the non-living things? Okay, fine, non-living things doesn't talk or more like us. Okay, fine children. Children, let's look at this picture. All of you look here. What can you see here, children? Look here. Yes, fine, these are animals. You can see the animals here. Fine children, can you name them? Yes, yes, one by one children. Yes, rabbit is there. Next, horse, fine. Then, camel, good. Cow, fantastic. Then, cat, fine. Then, dog, very good. Hen, superb. One more is there, no? Yes, sheep. Very good, children. So I'll give the right answer. Children, tell me, do you love animals? Do you love animals? Yes. Very good, children. Here is a question for you. Do you have a pet in your home? Yes, very good. Can you name them? Cow, then dog, very good. Then cat, fine children. Now tell me children, how do you play with them? You are going to play with the animals. Sometimes you are going to play with the animals, isn't it? Now tell me children, how do you play with them? Yes, you play with them sometimes by pulling its tail. Next, yes, you sit on its back. Then yes, you are going to shake hand to them. By this, you are going to enjoy and play with the animals. Isn't it, children? Excellent, children. Children, now let's look at the next picture. Look at the picture, children. What can you see here? What can you see in this picture? Yes, superb. Trees are there. Very good. Then, cycle. Very good. Then, boy. It's a toy, no? Yes, superb. Then, car, very good. Oh, it's a remote car. Fine, children, fantastic. Then, toys, very good. Toys are there. Then, doll, very good. Here is a question, children. Some might have played and talked with the dolls, isn't it? Have you ever noticed? Yes, you played with the dolls. You loved to play with the dolls. Okay, good children. Next, Apart from all these, do anybody made friendship with the nature? Apart from all these things, do anybody made friendship with the nature? No. Now, okay, children, now, what can you see in the nature? Tell me, children, what can you see in the nature? Yes, rivers, very good. Then, mountains, very good. Sun, superb. Then, rocks, very good. Animals, then trees, and so on. You are going to see so many things in the nature, isn't it? Good, children. Now, have you ever talked with any one of these things? No. Okay, children, listen here. When I was in 5th standard like you, I used to sit alone in the class. When I returned to home, I shared my feeling to the reflection of mine in the mirror. In the same way, here is a person who used to talk or share his feelings with the living beings but or non-living things. It doesn't talk or move like us, but he used to talk with that. Can you guess, children, who is the person and whom did he make as his friend? Think, children, can you guess who is the person and whom did he make as his friend? River? No, children. Then? Sun? No, children. Okay, children, let's see who is that person and who he make as his friends in the poetry. Friends. Before that, children, let's know the meaning of new words. Let's know the meaning of new words. Look here, children, all of you. Lie. Lie. L-I-E. Lie. Lie means to sleep on the back, face upwards. To sleep on the back, face upwards. Look here. Look at the picture. Who is there? Boy. Very good. A boy is there. What is the boy doing? A boy is lying under a tree. Very good. A boy is lying under a tree. Let's see the next word. Flickers. Flickers. F-L-I-C-K-E-R-S. F-L-I-C-K-E-R-S. Flickers means shines dimly. Flickers means shines dimly. Look here, children. What is this? Bulb. Okay, here bulbs are there. How does it look like? Yes, the bulbs are flickering. That means the bulbs are shines dimly. Have you got it? Okay, children, let's move to the next. Bent. Bent. Bent means sharply curved. Bent means sharply curved. Look here. Look at the picture. What can you see in that picture? Pencil. Very good. How is the pencil? Yes, the pencil looks like bent. The pencil is bent. Good, children. We shall move towards the next one. Lace. Do you know the meaning of lace? No, no, it is not that lace you are going to eat as a snack. It is a lace. L-A-C-E, lace means a decorative cloth which is made by weaving. Look here, children. You can see a varieties of laces here. These are varieties of laces. Can you see now here? So many varieties of laces are here. Okay? Let's move to the next. Steel. S-T-E-A-L, steel. Another steel is there, no? S-T-E-E-L, steel. That steel means that is a metal. Here, steel means to take something without permission. Without any permission, we are going to take, no? That is known as S-T-E-A-L, steel. Look here. What can you see in this picture? Who is he? Yes, you guess. You are guessing is right. He is a thief. Yes, a thief is running with the stolen bag. Very good. A thief is running with the stolen bag. Let's see the next one. Yes. Whisper. W-H-I-S-P-E-R. Whisper. Whisper means to speak quietly in a low voice. Whisper means to speak quietly in a low voice. Look here. What can you see here? Yes. A brother is whispering to his sister. A brother is whispering to his sister. Let's see the next word. Gentle. Gentle. Gentle means mild and kind. Gentle means mild and kind. Look here, look at the picture. Who is there in the picture? Yes, you are right. Mother and baby. Yes. Here, a mother is holding her baby gently. Look here. A mother is holding a baby gently. Did you all understand, children? Yes, very good. Now, open your text, children. Let's see the poem, Friends. Did you open, children? Yes, very good. Now, I'll going to recite the poem. You have to look at the poem and listen attentively. Are you all ready? Yes, good children. Now, poetry, Friends. This poem is written by Abby Fowell Brown. Yes, all of you repeat after me. Who is the poet here? Yes, Abby Fowell Brown. Very good, children. Now, look here, all of you, look at the text. Shall I? Shall we? Yes, children. Look here, all of you. How good to lie a little while and look up through the tree. The sky is like a kind big smile bent sweetly over me. The sunshine flickers through the lace of leaves above my head and kisses me upon the face like mother before bed. The wind comes stealing over the grass to whisper pretty things, and though I cannot see him pass, I feel his careful wings. So many gentle friends are near whom one can scarcely see. A child should never feel a fear wherever he may be. Who is the poet here? Yes, the poet is Abby Fowell Brown. Let's take a look at the first stanza now. Are you all ready, children? Okay, children. Look here, children, all of you. How good to lie a little while. What is the meaning of lie, children? Yes, good. As I told you, lie means to sleep on the back, face upwards. How good to lie a little while and look up through the tree. The sky is like a kind big smile. Yes, bently over me, bent sweetly over me. Look here, children. Where is the child? Yes, a child is lying under a tree. Little while. How good to lie a little while. Little while means for a short amount of time. A child is lying under a tree for a short amount of time. And when the child looks up through the tree, how does the sky looks like? Yes, look it there. Look there. Yes, the sky looks like a kind big smile which bends sweetly over me. Over me means who here? Me means a child. The sweet kind of smile bent over a child. Did you understand, children? Yes, now I'll going to ask questions to you. Now, look here, children. Well, how does the sky looks like? How does the sky looks like? Yes, you are right, children. The sky looks like a kind big smile. Very good, children. Okay, next question. Which is the rhyming word for while? Which is the rhyming word for while? Yes, the rhyming word for while is smile. Very good. Rhyming word for while is smile. Which is the ending sound here? Ending sound is I'll. Okay, children. Let's move towards the next stanza. That is second stanza. The sunshine flickers through the lace of leaves above my head. Look here, look at the picture. How does the sunshine flickers through the lace? Yes, flickers means, what is the meaning of flickers? Flickers means shines dimly. The sunshine, look here, the sunshine flickers through the lace. That means the sunshine shines dimly through the lace of leaves above my head. My head means whose head? Yes, my head means child's head. Very good. And kisses me upon the face. How does it kisses? It kisses like a mother before bed. How does the sunshine kisses to the child? It kisses when the mother going to kiss the child before the bed. In the same way, the sunshine kisses to her child before the bed. Did you understand, children? Yes, here is a question, children. Look here, how does the mother kisses to a child? In the same way, the sunshine kisses to a child's face. It is compared to a, when the sunshine kisses a child, it is compared to a, as the mother kisses her child before the bed. Did you understand, children? Yes. Next, here is the question, children. What do you mean by flickers? What do you mean by flickers? No. Flickers means not that one. Yes, very good, children. Flickers means shines dimly. Very good. Well done, children. Next. Where do sunshine flickers through? Where do sunshine flickers through? Yes, very good, children. Sunshine flickers through the lace. Very good. Lace of leaves. Superb, children. The last question here. Which is the rhyming word for lace? Which is the rhyming word for lace? Yes, very good, children. Rhyming word for lace is face. Lace and face are rhyming words. Okay, shall we move towards next? That is third stanza, children. Okay, fine, children. Let's move. Look here, children. The wind comes stealing over the grass to whisper pretty things. Look here. What is this? Yes, grass. You can see the grass. How is the grass looks like here? Yes, the grass is bent. Why? When does the grass bends? Yes, when the wind comes, the grass will bend. Okay. And though I cannot see him pass, I feel his careful wings. When the wind comes, it stealing. What is the meaning of stealing here? Yes, stealing means to take something without permission. Have you ever noticed the wind, children? Can we see the wind, children? No, we cannot see the wind, but just we can feel the wind, isn't it? In the same way here, the wind comes stealing over the grass. That means the wind comes without permission. Why does the wind come? The wind comes to pretty things, to whisper pretty things. What is the meaning of whisper? Yes, whisper means to speak quietly in a low voice. The wind is whispering with whom here? Yes, child. Very good. The wind is whispering with the child. And though I cannot see him pass, I means who here? Yes, child. Though the child cannot see the wind passes, him means wind. Very good. Wind passes. But I feel means a child feels his careful wings. His means whom here? Yes, winds. Yes, a child feels the wind, careful wings. Very good, children. Now, here is a question. Now tell me, children, what comes stealing over the grass? What comes stealing over the grass? Yes, you are right, children. Wind comes stealing over the grass. Next, children. Which is the rhyming word for things? Which is the rhyming word for things? Yes, well done, children. Rhyming word for things is wings. Very good. Things and wings are rhyming words. Shall we move towards the last stanza? Are you all ready? Okay, fine, children. So many gentle friends are near, whom one can scarcely see. So many gentle friends are near. Look here, how does the child looks like? Yes, it feels very happy. As you all always happy, no? In the same way, a child is also happy always. So many gentle friends are near, whom one can scarcely see. A child should never feel a fear, wherever he may be. So many gentle friends. Gentle means, what is the meaning of gentle? Gentle means mild and kind, isn't it? So many mild and kind friends are near the child. It can see scarcely. Scarcely means rarely. Though the child sees the friends rarely, but a child never feel a fear. Wherever the child may be, it never feels a fear. Okay, did you all enjoy the poem, children? Yes, excellent, children. You are good children, clever children. Here is a question, children. Now tell me, children, who are some of the gentle friends of the child in the poem? Who are some of the gentle friends of the child in the poem? Yes, very good. Wind. Then sunshine. Good. Sky. Very good. and then trees also. Okay, fine children, you are all very clever. That's why you give the right answer. Good children. Okay children, here is an activity. Okay, the first activity is, what you are going to do is, you have to match the following rhyming words. Okay, you have to match the correct rhyming words. Yes, here A and B column is there. I'm going to read the words in column A. First one, while. While. Next one, free. Free. Next, third one, head. Head. Next, fourth one, grass. Grass. Fifth one, near. Near. Now, words in column B. Me, bed, pass, fear, smile. What you are going to do is, you have to match the correct rhyming words. Yes. Here children, which is the rhyming word for while? Yes, anybody? Yes, very good. Rhyming word for while is smile. While and smile are rhyming words. Which is the ending sound here? I'll. Very good children. I'll is the ending sound. Shall we move towards the next? Yes. Second one is free. Free. Which is the rhyming word for free? Yes, it's me. Free and me are rhyming words. The next one, third one, head. Head. Which is the rhyming word for head? Bed. Very good. Head and bed are rhyming words. Next, fourth one, grass. Grass. Yes. Which is the rhyming word for grass? Yes, it is right. Pass. Grass and pass are rhyming words. Which is the ending sound here? Us. Us. Very good children. The last one children. Near. Near. Which is the rhyming word for near? Fear. Very good. Near and fear are rhyming words. Well done children. You've done a great job. Shall we move towards the next activity? Are you all ready with that? Are you all ready children? Okay, here we go with. What you are going to do is, here you have to identify the naming words in the following sentences. Here is the sentences. You have to identify the naming words here. Are you all ready? Yes, fine children. Let's start. First one, I am going to read the sentence. You have to identify the naming word in that. Okay? Okay children. First one, Raju is running. Raju is running. Which is the naming word in this sentence? Yes, Raju. Very good children, Raju. Because Raju is the name of a person. Okay children, fine. Let's move towards next one. This is a cow. This is a cow. Which is the naming word in this sentence? Yes, you are right. Cow. Superb children, cow. Because cow is the name of an animal. Super children. Let's move towards the third one. I have two pence. I have two pence. Which is the naming word in this sentence? Yes. Excellent. Pence. Pence is the right answer. Because pen is the name of a? Yes. Thing. It's the name of a thing. Let's move to the next one. Fourth one. We are going to Mysore. We are going to Mysore. Which is the naming word here? Mysore. Mysore. Very good. Yes, it's the name of a place. Very good. Yes, yes, you can see the palace also there. Very good, children. Let's move to the last one. Fifth and the last one. Okay? Today is Thursday. Today is Thursday. Which is the naming word here? Yes, Thursday. Fantastic, children. You all gave the excellent answers. Now in the last part is homework. You have to take down the homework. What is the homework here is, you have to list out the naming words from your surroundings. You have to list out the naming words from your surroundings. Yes, take down children. This is Rupa Anna from KPS Sagar. Thank you all children. I hope you all enjoy the rhyme. Thank you once again. Have a great day children.
ಹೊಸ ಹಾಡಿ.